Toolboxes. Today I'm gonna tell you a Bible devotion called The Parable of the Three Toolboxes. Before that, let's start our pledge first. Make sure to wash your hands, eat healthy food, go to sleep early, and wear a mask when you go outside. And now let's start the pledge. Stand up, salute, pledge to the Bible. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy words. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. Hand down. 1, 2, 3. I can do what the Bible says I can do. I can be what the Bible says I can be. I can have what the Bible says I can have. I declare it, I believe it, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Up. Salute. Pledge to the Indonesian flag. I pledge allegiance to the country Indonesia. I will love and honor my God and my country. I will serve the people and obey the law. I will lead my country to a greater Indonesia. Hand down. Jesus once told a story called the Parable of the Talents. In Jesus' story, a man was going away on a trip, so he called his servants together and gave each some of his money to use while he gone. I don't think Jesus will mind if I change the parable a little bit and tell you a story that I called the Parable of the Three Toolboxes. Once upon a time, there was a man who had a construction business. The man had to go away on a long trip, and so he called his three employees together and said,
I have to go on a long trip, and so I'm leaving you in three in charge. I have put together a toolbox for each of you to use to keep the business going while I'm gone.
The man then gave each of his employees a toolbox. The toolboxes contain all the tools the employees needed to do what the man expected of them. But since the three employees didn't all have the same abilities, each toolbox was different. To the first employee, he gave a very large toolbox filled with every tool that you can imagine. To the second employee, he gave a smaller toolbox, but one that still had a very good assortment of tools. To the third employee, he gave a very small toolbox with just a few tools, but enough tools for the employee to do what was expected of him. Then left to go on his trip. Well, when he returned, he called his employees together to see what they had done while he was gone. The first employee said, I knew that you had a great love for the homeless people of the world. So I used the toolbox that you gave me to build homes for the homeless. The second employee said, I knew that you have a great love for the elderly, so I used this toolbox you gave me to fix up the homes of elderly people who can no longer do the work themselves.
That is wonderful,
said the employer.
You have done such a good job that I'm putting you in charge of all the repair and maintenance work for the entire company.
Then he turned to the third employee and asked,
what did you do with the tools that I left for you?
I know that you are a very demanding boss and that you expect a lot from your employees. It was afraid that if I use these tools, you gave me that one of them might get broken, or that I might lose one of them and make you angry. I put the tools in a very safe place. They were all the time you were gone. Look, there are, just like new.
What a worthless employee you are. I didn't give you the tools for safekeeping. I gave them to you to use in my business. You are fired!
Since they had proven that they will make good use of them, he took the man's toolbox and divided the tools between the other two employees. I think this story is a good picture of what God has done in us. He has given each of us tools to use to building His kingdom. Who don't all have the same tools, but God expects us to use whatever tools He has given to us. If we do, He will give us even more, but if we don't, He may take them away and give them to someone who will use them. Listen to the words of Jesus, for everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even when he has, will be taken from him. Everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even when he has, will be taken from him. Matthew 25, verse 29. Dear Lord, help us to be faithful in using the gifts that you have given to us to help others and to build us the kingdom. In Jesus we pray, amen. Hi friends, I hope you enjoyed this Bible devotion called The Parable of the Three Toolboxes. I hope it's meaningful. Stay safe, stay healthy, and bye friends.